this is a topic that we are calculating as a complement to the model. We assume that the model is correctly designed, and we are using the model to further calculate vulnerability to poverty. We calculate poverty or relative poverty using disposable income. And in the presentation, I will talk about poverty and vulnerability, some concept or definition. Then we will, present the tax simulation, then the vulnerability estimation and some results. To start, then, why are we doing this? We know that over time people might flow in and out of the poverty. So this is a random sample. Sometimes people say it's for people in the threshold, it's a lottery. Sometimes are poor, sometimes are not poor because of the way poverty is measured. The poverty, the concept of vulnerability to poverty considers the probability of being affected by external shocks. And in developing countries, vulnerability is not considered. And see, so this is some kind of model to suggest for policy design. Then, what's the difference between poverty and vulnerability? In poverty, we are using and we are measuring, and this is an ex post measure. This is, we know who is poor after the damage is done. Then the difference is vulnerability is an ex ante. We have to identify who are prone to be poor. So this is a complement. I would say it's a dynamic estimation of poverty. Then how are we estimating vulnerability? Vulnerability is a probability of being poor in the future. So we have here that a person is considered has a probability of being poor in the future when the next period or the future consumption is less or equal to the poverty line. And the poverty line is given by the characteristic of the household. And the external shocks also. And where X is the household characteristics in age, sex, number of children, and some other characteristics. Beta are the state of the economy. Alpha is the household level effect, also where the household is currently situated. And E, the airplane, is the idiosyncratic factors. That those are the shocks. It might be disease, sickness, unemployment, and some other characteristics. So, vulnerability is the probability of becoming poor. And that's a function of the expected consumption in the future. So and the variability of the consumption. In this case, we are using as a proxy of consumption the disposable income. When there's enough data, or in developing countries, especially, or developed countries, there's longitudinal data of a sufficient length of time. I would say 10, 15, 20 years. But in developing countries, we don't have that luxury, I would say, to follow people through time. So we have only one observation at a time, and that's the limitation to estimate the probability of becoming poor. So we are using purely mathematically or econometric model to estimate vulnerability. What is the methodology, and we use echo models of the mode designed for Ecuador. It uses a household national survey on income and expenditure. This was done in 2011. The survey was given to 150,000 individuals, and that gives 39 or almost 40,000 households. That gives an average of 3.1, 3.2 persons per household. What's the estimation strategy? Yeah, we use we estimate poverty and vulnerability to poverty by using EcoMod and running the program for 2011 to 2016. Now, and since the model is set for 2011, and besides the vulnerability, it has a lot of a couple of strong assumptions. We assume here in the ECO model so that there's no labor market changes. And we estimate simply the tax benefit system. Based on that, on the ECO model, we have household head. This, just to summarize, that as usual, I would say worldwide, women are the most disadvantaged sector of the society. For example, we have here, for example, the median age for females, female household head are older. They have less education, more. For example, women have 52% at most primary education, but men have a higher percentage. And at the end, social security, women, no social security, almost two-thirds of household women don't have social security. Then what are the results? We have that the tax policy benefits are designed for the purpose of distributing the income. For example, the share of paid taxes, almost the totality are paid for the richest decile, like 90%. At the same time, social security or social insurance contribution is proportionally paid by the richest decile, the richest population. At the same time, the benefits or the redistribution of the income is given 0.5% to the poorest sector of the population. So this just shows how the tax policy in Ecuador is doing what it should be doing. So these are the results of the ECO mod. Using these results, we use to calculate the vulnerability results, and then we have here. Given that we are calculating poor and no poor population and vulnerable and no vulnerable population, we have these four groups of households. We have that 35% of the households are poor. Anyway, they might be vulnerable or not vulnerable, but the policy or the policy is attending this group of people, but we have to concentrate in this, not poor and vulnerable. And these are the group of households who, given the shocks, different shocks, and the idiosyncratic characteristics of the household, they are in and out of poverty. And what we have to stress is that, for example, the poor vulnerable, this is the maximum income, $155.3 per month. And these are poor. And the no poor with the minimum income of 155, 60 cents, this 30 cents of difference in income doesn't make any or much difference in the well-being. So this, for policy purposes, this is poor, but this is not poor because it's, but someone who has in this case 30 cents higher of higher income of 30 cents, that doesn't make non-poor. Probably they are they have the same well-being characteristics. So this is the group of households that the policy should take care, because they are the potential poor, and there's no difference in welfare. And this is the what this estimation is helping to complement the ECO model. And what we have when we combine poverty and vulnerability? We have here, these are, we see this, the gray bar is the poverty. We see that during these 5 years, the poverty level hasn't changed too much. 23%, 24%. So that means that the tax policy has been consistent through time because of the results we saw. But we see that the vulnerability through time has been decreasing from 11 to 8% in 5 years. These are only 3 points of vulnerability, but statistically significant. So this means that the distribution of the tax policy or of taxes has been benefiting to the vulnerable. And so to fight against poverty, we should consider these two household groups. The poor, the ones who are assisted by the normal policy, but we should include these, the vulnerable, so we would have to assist around 1/3 of the population. So because of time, we don't go through the model, but what do we have as a conclusion? That microsimulation can be used to estimate vulnerability to poverty based on cross-sectional data. Yeah, so in that case, since we don't have longitudinal econometrically, we can calculate those figures. In conclusion, around 20% of the population is identified as poor and vulnerable, and 25% no poor and vulnerable. And those are who have to be considered. In this case, I would say 45% of the population. Based on these results and this model, we have to exploit the advantages of EcoMod, use to identify the future poor households, since they are exposed to all the shocks that can happen in the economy. And this model can account for changes in the labor market in a vigorous way. Yeah. So, well, we have have to now cast the model every year, and that helps a lot. And this EcoMod, some figures, those, some pictures, these are biased pictures. We have this, this is Quito, the capital. There's much light, don't see, but we have an idea. Thank you very much.